All right, this is getting set up. And voila. All So yeah, I just wanted, like I said, I feel like I go over so many old songs, and I know that's like helpful in some ways, but I don't know, I just feel like I want to mess around with some new ideas. So I'm going to start off with this technique that I just recently learned that's pretty cool. Sound. Bing. Let me see if. So I have stereo and high fidelity mode on, and I think if I remember correctly, Ollie, do you remember how we did it? I remember you got it. Do you have to select something on your end?
I don't remember, to be honest.
All right, that's fine.
I think you have to go up to the top left corner and hit turn on original sound. I
Oh
just did
yeah,
it.
I think that was it, yeah.
Okay,
Yeah,
cool. So it
yeah.
works that way.
I think
Nice.
so.
So, this technique I'm going to start with is a cool thing I saw from this video, and it's like a really simple concept. But once you like see it done, you're kind of like, oh, this is cool. So, I believe if I remember correctly, I'm gonna go and find like basically like an atmosphere noise. So it's like it could be like a train station, it could be birds outside, it could be whatever. So you just take like noise, and it's cool when you have like a lot of variety going on. So these are like birds. Oh, you probably can't hear because I didn't change the.
Hello, you handsome devils. Sorry, I'm just popping in. My allergies are killing me.
Yeah, is it like strange time for allergies right now?
Oh man, I'm dying, dude.
Yeah, my
I'm
sister was all sniffly, and I was like, I don't know why I'm not. Huh. Spring. But nice to have you, Dan.
always glad to be here. Always glad to see everybody.
So I'm gonna try to find. I mean, this is a long file. Let's see. Ooh, this could be good. Yeah, okay. So this is like a train station. So what I'm gonna do. Am I on C1? I can never tell. Yeah, or I'm on C3, which is like the fault. So I'm going to make this quite long. Let's say like 16 length. Yeah. So what we're going to do is take this audio and put just to keep it all Ableton stock EQ8. I should give credit to the guy I watched some video on this about, but I, to be honest, actually forget who it was and where it was. But this guy was very, he did a really nice video about this, and maybe one day I will figure out who it was and give him credit. But basically, we all know that the note A is like a standard for tuning, and we typically go towards 440 hertz for A. And people argue about like natural, you know, that actual natural pitch of A, which is this whole other conversation. But for like most standardized tuning, we use 440 as A. And so if you take any audio file, and I also didn't even need to do this with simpler. I could have just done this by throwing it in, and I'm just going to do that so it's a little more normal. So we have audio. It doesn't need to be simpler. If you put an EQ and get rid of, like, you can get rid of all these except for one. If you set this to 440, you're going to create an A note just based on the fact that it's boosting that frequency, and it doesn't matter how. You can do it like really tiny like this. And so when I play it, you guys hear a slight faint like ooh.
Oh my God, that's actually crazy, yeah.
So if you keep boosting this, you just get a note because it's you're just cranking up the frequency of a audio file. So like anywhere you go, and you know you could collectively take all of these, and I don't know if you can select multiple. No, but you could make it any note. You can go up here. You can make a weird chord if you really want. But we want to do A because we're going to turn this into an instrument. So it's cranking, so I might not go that high. I could probably reduce these a little bit. So that's cool. I like that. Now we take that, and you can do this in Logic too. It'd just be the equivalent of using this, doing all this with Logic plugins. I just like Ableton because you can see it all pretty easily. And what we're going to do is freeze, and in the case of Logic, you would bounce. So now we're going to get this new audio file that has A just sustained the whole time in it. We're going to flatten. So it looks slightly different. I think it's even clipping a little here. Whatever. It's fine. So you could use simpler, but this guy in this video, I really should figure out his name. I feel bad just like totally jacking his idea and not crediting him. But he used sampler because there's a little bit more flexibility with sampler. And so what you could do is take this new frozen file, and how do you do this? I have to go like this and then go like that. Drag it in, and now if I were to mute the original and then just start playing like my keyboard. Oh. So now you can hear little notes. So I can play chords like. So that's pretty cool. Now where it starts to get really interesting is you can start to get into, I believe there are some, you can kind of like add a sense of granular synthesis to this if you use the modulation section. So let's turn on like LFO. Well, I guess this is something that always drives me nuts is when like you have three LFOs, but one of them is like hard locked to like volume filtered. I get it. It's like an easy function thing, but it's just like, I always want to do LFO one because my brain's like OCD and then, you know, it's like locked to these other parameters, but regardless. So now we'll take LFO 2 and maybe go to, I think actually the way this guy did it was he set loop. Where is it? So now I have a loop. So if I were to press play, like check it out, if I were to go. This should now loop back and forth and then go backwards. No, why are you not?
It's funny because I think I put the link of the video that you watched on the chat a few months ago.
No way!
Was it by Will Hatton?
Maybe. Is he British, I think?
Yeah.
Okay, then this is the guy I'm totally jacking his idea of. So I feel better now that I've figured out some credit. Mm. Yeah, so basically you can, now it's finally looping. In the sustain mode, you can set a loop and it'll go forward and reverse. And now where it starts to get interesting is, I can't remember if you did a long loop or a short loop, but basically you can start messing around with the modulation section in like, you can go loop start and then kind of, let's just like crank it up and see what happens. And I think you can see it. Okay, so that's not doing what I want to do. So maybe it is loop length. Nope. All right. Let's keep trying. Sample offset? I don't know. Well, this is sample start. We'll try a few of them at once and just see what happens. But what I mean, you could do this with like Granulator too. So I could just like drag this into another type of plugin that would do this automatically. But what I'm trying to do is have an LFO like start the sample at random points because, you know, with the three EQs that we just used, you're going to get that A note anywhere. And so now what you want to like start to do is have like randomness come into the start point of where you're playing on. And so, let's see. Maybe my frequency is just too low. If there was sample start, I'd be using that, but I don't think there is. Sample start.
Question for you, Pierce.
Yeah, what's
say,
up?
Say the background, you know, that crowd noise was like a little too much.
Yeah.
I mean, would you just take off? I'm kind of curious because, like, you know, you could create something really awesome and unique out of this.
Yeah.
But what if kind of that main audio file is just bleeding through it too much? Well, kind of just.
There's actually two ways you could do this. You could make the audio file lower in the original thing that you do with the three EQs so that the like ratio between the note that you're producing and then the audio file is like, you know, there's a bigger gap between the volumes, you know? But then there's also like, you can do all this filtering. I'm going to try to find the actual preset that I have made with this because that'll just be easier to show you. I think I have it. Noise 440 pad. So let's see, this is the first one I ever made and I'll try and figure out what I did to make the stuff move around. Okay, so now you see it's moving around on the screen, right? So now when I play chords, you get that constant A, but it's just kind of floating through the audio file to give you all this random other stuff, which is really cool.
That's beautiful.
So let me find. Yeah, it is kind of going nuts. I wonder what's doing that. That's weird because I'm just using like native plugins right now. But perhaps this little trick is. So, in the modulation section, I had loop start. Oh, perhaps it was the... Let me try to redo this. So I had loop start. I had a different waveform for this. Kind of similar. So what is the difference between these two? I have no idea what I'm doing wrong. But I'm clearly forgetting something. Very odd. Well, I'll use the one I already made. But so Dan, like you were asking, I filtered some of this stuff out so you can kind of like get rid of these pop bits if you want. And then you get kind of just like muffled voices. I'm just gonna kind of freestyle and make some. So now you kind of just have this wonderful little bed to start your song with. And say I wanted to do a different key, I can just kind of like transpose it around. It's gonna drive me nuts that I'm not able to recreate on this new one. I don't know why. It's all the same. Everything is the same. But I think I could also just do this. Let me see what would happen if I did simpler. Because I know that there is a function that. It's not as extensive as an LFO. Well, what I could do, honestly, is like use the LFO. And just map it to like. All right, this is not going well. Let's see. Okay, this is kind of working. So every note you'd play. So I could even just match these and see what would happen. Another EQ. And so if this were to like keep looping throughout your song, you'd get like different little bits of that audio every time, which is quite cool. So let me correct this loop. Oh my god. It's getting a little wacky. And I would probably make this one a little quieter because it's a little more bold. You could even maybe like pan these left and right. I don't know if you guys can even hear this one. Go like group and then do like auto pan and then put this on and put it on. I love this random shape. You do it kind of slow with like a low amount, so it's just kind of like slightly moving back and forth. Try to use the new hybrid reverb because that's apparently dope and I have not used it much. And I put it on the channel. So like I already have ideas for this, so I'm gonna go and maybe pull up Labs just to get ideas going. And like, this is how I would make music normally. It's just like creating some kind of like jumping point to an idea. You know what I mean? Like, for me, it's typically like rhythms and strange like percussion sounds, or it's like these kind of atmospheres. Psycho, I'm gonna put this four band OTT I've made on it. Lower it slightly. I'm also gonna, I mean, it's funny, I thought I would get away from doing this, like having effect racks that I use all the time, but I still do it all the time. So I'm going to use... Where are effect racks in the new... Maybe it's utilities? Yeah. Where is it? Piano effects. Yeah, I use this all the time. But it makes life easy. Oh! Crashed my computer. Tight. All right, let's try that again.
Oh, no.
Imagine all that's gone.
No.
I honestly, dude, I would cry, but it should hopefully be saved.
Yeah.
When you
let's it. See. Round two. It looks like it's here. So maybe I won't use that effect rack and just start fresh. All right, let me try this again. Funny, this got unmapped.
Honestly, dude, you might just need to freeze both the. Haven't already the second one as well.
The all of the like moving around stuff.
Yeah, because there's just no way that your CPU is gonna handle this.
Yeah, maybe it is best. All right, so I'll just freeze these. I should also save. That's like there used to be this thing that happened where. I think it was in Logic. If your project crashed once, you'd be able to get it back. But then if that crash crashed again, it would be like gone. So if you didn't like open it back up and save, I don't know if that was like an old version of Logic, but I just remember that happening a few times. So I'm going to go.
Yeah, it like auto saves if you don't save it. So you can recover your project. But I think, yeah, I think only does it once.
Yeah.
Then you have to save it.
It's flattened. And thankfully for this pad, like I don't really want to change it much more. I like it for just it being this bed. And I could even take like a chop of it and loop it if I really wanted, but it's a good starting point. Okay.
It seems like a cool little...
What's up?
I was just saying, it seems like a really good technique to go back with that kind of nature ambiance class we did, and then throw this technique on there to see what will happen randomly, you know?
Yeah, definitely. And that's kind of what my idea for this class was, like sort of putting some of these techniques together to show kind of in context what I would be doing. I like special reverb. Let's try special reverb. I haven't really messed with this too much, the new reverb. Whoa, all right, well that's like a bit crusher. Whoa, that's cool. Interesting. Let's try Droney Cave too. These are cool. Oh, I put Droney Cave accidentally on the... Let's see. I actually quite liked it on it with 100%. I need drums so I actually can. So I'm gonna use another plugin that I think I've shown you guys that I quite like. It has a funny name. It's called Skaka. But it's an amazing shaker plugin. So you basically just hit a note, press play, and you have a shaker. But the best part about it, you can go like this. So you have all these options. I could play any key on my keyboard and have all these different options. But then you can go into them. So like this shaker, I can like customize this. Like I can make it like, you can pitch it. You can give it like some human feel. Oh, interesting. I haven't even seen this. Smartness. Wow, you can make your shakers smart. Add a little shuffle. So that's pretty cool. So now, if I were to listen to this, just the shaker. Kick two to get the things pumping. The preset that Gordon made that I can take no credit for, that I use all the time. AKA the leading roll kick on every single song we've made. Also, to just be sassy, let's put a little Pro L on the master so it sounds kind of cool. I know you're not supposed to do this, but I really want to. And then I think we've talked about Diva a little bit. Honestly, if you have Diva, my favorite way to use it recently has just been to go to presets, and then you can go to these templates, and basically these are all like default presets for really famous synthesizers. So it's like, this is probably like the Alpha Juno or some synth named that. This is like Juno 60, this is probably a 106, this is a Jupiter 8, or no, that's a Jupiter 6, Jupiter 8. I think this is supposed to be a Mini Moog. Yeah. Then like a mono poly at Korg, and then these are like MS-20s, and then I don't know what this one is. But what's really cool is like for bass sounds, like say I want to do like the Rev 2 of a MS-20. Now it's just like set up like, and you can kind of like, this is a good way of crafting your own like really standard sounding synth sounds, you know what I mean? Like not like super wacky sound designing stuff. So for this, I would want just like a pretty straight normal like baseline, not anything crazy, because I want to basically just replicate this. So what is that? What is that? D. And I kind of want to do this like, let's say, thank you. So to me, like, based on the like pad and just the feeling of these melodies, I kind of want to do like a melancholy kind of dreamy dance idea where it kind of, it's not super in your face. It's supposed to, you're supposed to kind of just like drift along with it. So in my mind, I was like, it'd be cool to do this syncopated bass thing or whatever, dotted eighth note bass thing that almost never goes back to like the one. It just keeps cycling. I always like stuff like that. And so I'll just kind of duplicate it until it's at its end, and then I actually like that note instead. So we'll lower this, add a little compressor. Because I'm just going off of what I've been doing lately, I might do just like a 909 hat, and I really like using the Ableton Core one. Yeah, it's just a nice knocky little guy like that. So let's do that just to have a little backbone, maybe shorten it. You know, it's another cool Ableton thing I've discovered is this note echo. You can put it on like before, and it acts like an echo, but just for me, it's very bizarre. I don't really like understand it, but it's cool. So, like, listen. So you can get like. Just really quick echoes, but it's not actually echo. It's MIDI messages. So, like, that's kind of cool that, like, and then it kind of gives your stuff a little different groove. So that's good. Thing I've been doing is it this envelope? Oh, apparently now it's echoing out. So I should probably turn down the feedback. Yeah. What am I looking for? Envelope follower. It's, I guess it's not in this section, it's in the audio effects and then modulators. Envelope follower is what I'm looking for, yes. So I like this one too because, or no. I'm looking for, is it shaper? No. What am I looking for? I used it the other day. What is it? Do you mind if I just jump between a different project real quick? Let me save this. You guys feel free to ask me any questions based on this if you want. Yeah, I was doing this edit of a song. Oh, I guess it was Shaper. Okay. Let me go back. There's so many different names for things that do kind of the same thing. All right. So, Shaper. Yes, okay. Oh, I didn't see this because the video windows. I always forget that I can just make myself not have a, like, I won't be able to see you guys, but then doesn't block all of Ableton. So I'm going to map this to the cutoff. So now if I were to just go like this, the bass would sound like this. Which is cool if that's what you want, but I like kind of just going through these. now it's going to give it just basically like random cutoff. How on there has to be some science behind the filter, but on MS-20s and like clones, the pulling up the resonance doesn't really take away that much low end usually. Or I also am listening on earbuds, so I shouldn't even say anything. Back to our piano. Ooh, that's loud. It's funny because this, I changed the chord from this, but that'll be nice, like, eventually to go down to that note. But I want to do the. Lengthen this out so we can hear more of the atmospheric stuff kind of going in and out, and maybe I'll like bring things in and out and see. So like, say we started with like this. Maybe I'll kind of find some like loops to chop up, drum loops to kind of fill in some of these gaps. And like some loops are gonna sound ridiculous because I get so many different ones, but. features. I'm not looking for something to just throw in on it completely, but I'll look for like a little thing to loop. This is actually kind of sweet. Let me see what I can do with this, because it gives it a bit more swing. And it's really swung, so I might actually make it not swung. To keep it as it was originally, it's like that's what loops are for, but most of the time I don't like how it sounds when it is in full, and then occasionally I'll come across one like this where I'm like, oh, that just works, so I'm just gonna use it. So let's keep those snares. This sounds like the second time around. Bum, 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 bum. So maybe it would be like bum, bum, mm. Maybe I would go like this. Times you're not really going to get super bored of it because there's like a little bit of variety, and maybe I would add more. I don't know. But for now, let's keep that, because then eventually we'll go to that other chord, which is cool. Actually, to be honest, I could just go through more of the scacca and see. So you can add like a second loop. That's cool. do is to do like 6 bars, and then it kind of never really repeats the same way. So like, let me kind of customize some go away, go away, go away. No. I'm just kind of clicking randomly to see what happens. Yeah, that's cool. So, like, based on stuff we've talked about, where do you think we go next? Because honestly, this is where I get stuck all the time. I will make an idea like this and then just be like, eh, I don't really know what to do now. So I'm open to suggestions. I want to make this a little more.
Maybe clear. Like some vocals, like Nest to the Back. Where it's like a kind of not like singing, but kind of like
what we could do is there's that plugin. I never use it because it's really big, but let's see if it works well on this. It's called Exhale. Okay.
When I hit this point, Pierce, I always oftentimes try to hear a melody over the top of it.
Yeah, that's it. And I usually do that too, but the thing that's tough is that if I don't have an idea, it's like all I ever come up with is just like horrible melodies, you know what I mean? Like it's one of those things that kind of has to be like there from the get-go, or else it just like never really comes. It's very weird. Why can't I hear you? Come on, I'm playing you. Let me try a different thing really quick. Like a contact one. Okay, that works. Oh, I think you have to be in a certain range. So let's see. These are notes. You know what's funny? I think one of the reasons why I don't like this plugin is every time you switch presets, it's like, are you sure? And it kind of drives me nuts. Let's see slices. And something that's kind of cool is you can set the key that you're in. So let me figure this out with my brain. Mm-hmm. I guess we're in D major. So I can go major, D. Why does that sound wrong? Oh, no, this is labs. It should be. Let me try another preset. It's funny because, like, based on Ollie's suggestion, I would probably find something better if I just sang something into my phone than going through all this. But let's see. Yeah, most of these kind of sound dorky. But it is cool that you can, like, narrow it down by key. Yeah, I'm not loving these. It's all very like, ooh. All right, let's move on. So maybe for the sake of knowledge and the way that we've been doing things, I will record my own thing in my phone. So let's see. So I might even just do like a scratch vocal kind of thing to see what would happen. Chopping. So let's say class chopping. Actually, you know what's a funny thing about iPhones? The other day I was recording drums and I couldn't get one of my microphones to work that I was going to use as kind of like a room mic. And out of like frustration, I just took my iPhone and started recording on voice memos at the same time that I was doing like the regular drum take. And now I use like an iPhone recording as part of the like whole mix of drums, and it's awesome because it sounds like kind of like a blown out, like over compressed take, and if you kind of like blend that in on top of the like really clean dynamic takes, it sounds very interesting. I was very happy with the results. So let me get my little funny vocal just to see if it's a good starting point, because I could even just chop little bits of it. Let me wait for it to come onto my computer. Come on. Or I'll just text it to myself like I usually do. Text to me. I can go over that song that I mentioned if you guys are interested in that. I just thought this would be more knowledge-filled, you know? But I am getting to that point that Jeff and I have talked about of not knowing where else to go with this. But all right, here's my little funny vocal. What was it? Oh, it's warped. So I didn't give myself proper time in because I'm dumb, but I'll kind of figure out where this goes. Where the up here. So I could just take this, and what I'm going to do is kind of like duplicate this stuff to make it a full loop, add some fades. I just discovered this trick, or what is it? If you do Command Option F, it adds crossfades to every edge, which is quite nice, and they're pretty small, so I like that. You guys know I like my fades. And I also think you can go like this and do the same key command, and it just does a little quick fade like that, which is nice. Better than what I've done in the past. Ooh. Okay, so I'm going to consolidate that. So it's a loop. So I could just like loop this, or I could try to pull it into simpler and mess around with it a little bit. I wonder if I have my effect rack saved from nice to the back. See, utilities, audio effect rack. Back to the NES vocal chain, nice. Don't crash, please. Don't blow up my ears. I don't know if you guys have ever put on like an audio effect rack while you're playing a song. Sometimes it makes, it, oh boy. Look at all those plugins. Oh my god. Oh jeez. What are you doing, man? What are you doing? Alright, back to usual. Oh cool. That was all the now I'm just like moaning a lot. Let's see. Oh, it has I need to change this to D major. It's actually kind of cool. Maybe I'll lower the threshold of the slicing. Maybe I would like filter this more and make it kind of more mysterious. Oh my god, there are so many plugins on this. Oh no, 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 no. Don't do that. Oh goodness gracious, what are you doing, dude? Go away. Alright, I'm making you guys small again because I keep moving you around. Alright. Actually, you know what's a good solution? If you guys have retro color, they kind of have some. There's a few presets that are kind of cool that make stuff sound like they're coming out of like a speaker in a mall or something. This one. Actually might be a good way to mess around is literally just go Ooh, we can use another new Ableton thing. Here we go. There are these new Max for Live things called Inspired by Nature. Nature. Oh, it's in PAX probably. PAX. No? Come on, where are you? Inspired by Nature. Okay, here we go. If you go to like bouncy notes, let's just see what happens. So this is on, hold on. These are, what notes are these? I don't know where I am on my keyboard, so. Okay, C1. So if I go back to this bouncy notes, turn it on. Okay. Is there a way to sync this at all? Or is that, does that just defeat the purpose of this whole plugin? Okay, not into it. Let's do a Euclidean sequencer instead. And see if we can get an interesting patch out of this. We need this to go down. So we're in the C1 range, I think. See, this is better. To me, this is kind of like a like B melody. CPU. kind of cool. I mean, it's a little like cheesy, but it's interesting. Just based on like showing you guys how I would come up with like a little idea like that. And you know, I just recorded that into my phone and then added 3,000 plugins to it. But I love stuff like this Euclidean sequencer where, you know, normally you could just put it on like a piano thing. Like I've done it with, we could do it right now. Check this out. So I'll duplicate labs. Also, I don't know what's echoing that much, but it's kind of dope. Anyways, so I'm gonna do this, put Euclidean sequencer. And actually, I don't need the chords. All I need is a scale, MIDI scale function. So if I just go like this and make it, let's make it 8 bars. Legato it. What is giving me CPU problems? Let's freeze some stuff. It is this. So, let's say we like this. So let's freeze it and tell it to go away. Freeze. Do you guys find this interesting? Like, is it helpful? Anything?
Yeah. I mean, yeah. It's always, everyone is always going to come at a project differently. So it always provides some sort of insight of how we might, you know, go about it differently next time.
Yeah, I mean, I know that I learned this. I guess that's why I go do this approach, is like I learned the best by just watching someone do exactly what they would be doing rather than being like, so this is parallel compression. And you know, I think those kind of lessons are important, but sometimes it's cool to just be like a fly on the wall in how I would make an idea.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
And let's hope this freezes successfully. Okay, I'll flatten it. I want to change the velocity. Yes, I have velocity random on both of these. Random. I think this one is too high in pitch. And I might try some different instruments within labs because this, I don't want to just keep using the same piano. Ooh, Oh, cool. Look at this. There's a little tail on this vocal thing I did. Is there anything usable? Sometimes tails are cool. That one is not very cool, so. Stuff in D major all the time. And it might actually be cooler if it was like Diva or something. So let me get Diva. Ooh, yeah. My computer loves Diva. There's this one I used to use all the time called Frost Piano. Maybe it's the Euclidean sequencer. I don't know. I'll take these off just for a sec to see. No, I think it's just Diva. All right, we'll try something else. I'm gonna go back to labs and see if there's anything cool. Mostly pad stuff, but maybe like a music box. So I just divided it by two twice to make it slower, to see if that would just make it a little more interesting. That could be a verse. And it would repeat again. So. And then maybe here it would go to like a pre-chorus. And maybe this is where it goes to that other nice note. Actually, now I have ideas for this. So this is what's weird, is like sometimes you could give up and just be like, I don't have any more ideas. And then other times you just like randomly will be like, oh yeah, I know what to do next. So let's see. We're gonna do a little, this is gonna be the pre-chorus, all right. I'm doing a class. Okay. No. No. So, dun, 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 dun. I was thinking of going back to this like happy one, but it might be kind of cool to go to like a little sad section. And then, why is this looping there? Sometimes I get all thrown off when I'm doing Ableton clips. Oh yeah, this is why. Tangent horn. Aren't like super final. I'm just kind of like going with what I'm hearing things. Like I might add some more voices to this to be like. And also like I've mentioned this in previous classes, I could be using theory and like make my life easy, but I for some reason just always like to just go with my ear first and kind of just like plug in notes, because sometimes you just come up with weird chords that you wouldn't normally. Gordon would call Gord chords. He always does this type of like build-up cadence thing. It's really funny. Something I'm trying to practice more often is like not always having like three note chords, because sometimes just having kind of like shell chords almost are really cool. I don't know if that's the correct term. I think shell chords are like the top three notes on guitar when you omit the bass and the fifth or third or whatever. So just these kind of like fragmented chords, because sometimes it makes this chord a lot more powerful if you don't have third note in there to go up to it. So let's do this all together because I don't even remember. Maybe I would go to like a different chord here, or like a little different voicing where it's like, and then boom, bam. So I would go then, just to like finish it off kind of differently. And then bam, bam. That up, and yeah, but now if it were to go back to that one, would it sound cool? I don't know, because I'm going based off my ears, not. There could probably be a better I mean, it kind of see what that sounds like. Ooh, you know what could actually be kind of cool is to then go dun, dun, and then have kind of a, like a little variation on that first chord. Dun, dun, dun. And then, because something I do a lot is, you know, just like when it's the end of the progression, just go back to like the same thing. But maybe there's a way I can kind of morph this into something a little bit different when it's like the chorus moment. Now that the chords are kind of growing. So maybe now we can go maybe not that one. Let's see what that doing octaves. Go into this kind of more like jazzy chord. Let's see. Kind of weird, but let me work with it. And then back to. I could even take that little. Velocity, so it's just peeking through. And maybe no. Back to the top. it's kind of cool. It's like weird-ish, but I might be able to work with it. And I'm gonna use these chords that I always use from, what is it from, plugins, TAL Audio. This one, TAL. What is it called? Noisemaker. And I always use one preset. Try out the old. I'm gonna save because Arturia always freaking crashes on me. Or no, this is, they did a new one. I think it's this, the Juno chorus. It's actually quite good. Let's go configure, not that parameter, this one, yes. Let's go slow, random, with some jitter and some smooth. Cool, relax. Less dissonant and go like da da da.
I want to add a little
yo, what's up?
I mean, this is hard. It's so basic, but like just throwing like a little like white noise, like down sweep or something, like, you know, side chain to the kick as it kind of drops into the chorus.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah,
give it a little more air along with the TAL noise.
And you know what I've been doing lately is, to go back to our atmosphere sounds, I've just been making like downlifters out of that.
It's or so that. Much, yeah.
It's so much more interesting sounding than like a, I mean, I could use it. We should just use the original sample we've had. Like, we'll find a little moment. Oh, it has the 440 on it. So let me find that same one. It's called Raw Travel. Ah. Cool, I think it's the end of a whistle. So if you just use like a little bit of that. Can't even tune it. What key are we in? A D major? Vinyl distortion is not the move. Just for fun. But like mainly when I'm doing this stuff, I'm not even thinking about like transition stuff. I'm just thinking about like structure, chords, like the way that the song progresses. Thank you. So sometimes to do this, I like pull those out of the way. Regular Juno. That chord is not my favorite. It's that note. A little better. I should do that here. This plugin is insane how much it actually sounds like. This little send is really cool. It's just like a radio kind of filter send. Without it, it just occupies this little nice part of the spectrum that gives it a little more like. Cool. I mean, yeah, this is like an idea to me. I wouldn't say it's something I could see finishing, but it's like something that I'm glad I made it and put some ideas into it. But I'll probably listen to it again in a few days and see how it makes me feel. Thank you. just to spice things up, let's do a little bit of this. Ready? 16th notes. Oh, there's going to be echo. Let's do, I just wanted to do rides. Situation. I'm curious, since you guys have seen me use it so much, has anyone gotten Nerve and does anyone use it? No?
No. Oh. I was going to, but it was a bit expensive, so I thought maybe.
Yeah, not. It is a little pricey, but I love it. It's funny, like, I have recommended it to so many people and no one ever gets it. But
I honestly just think it's just because most DAWs already have that sort of thing built in. But, like, obviously, you know, like, the Ableton's drum kit is way different than this because it doesn't have, like, a preloaded set of sounds.
Yeah, I just my thing, and I'm sure you guys know, is the fact that you can flip through samples really fast, because I haven't found a single other thing, like, in any DAW that does that.
I'm sure I'll get it someday.
What's up?
I'm sure I'll get it someday.
Yeah, I'd say eventually. It's pretty awesome. Yeah.
Maybe Black Friday or something.
Yeah. He actually, I think Steve is making a newer one. Like a Nerf 2, which is pretty sweet. But I just like that I can go. Clap snare thing. Yeah, like one of those. The old school way. I think finding claps and snares is my least favorite part of producing, to be honest. It just, like, you have to look for so long and, like, yeah, just, it's very irritating. I'm gonna go back to my folder. Let's see. I also think I just collect the wrong sounds. I'll, like, collect things because I'm like, that sounds cool, not like, I have an application for that, you know. I just bought these. They're really dope. And I could do, like, rim shots. And just be like, random. Random, random, random. so honestly, this is probably a good place to stop because I would normally go away. What are you doing? I would normally kind of take a break from this and then come back to it in like a day or two and either say this is cool or this is not cool. And yeah, this is, I mean, basically how I do all of my ideas. Just and the ones that, like, there's certain ones that I can finish in a day because all the ideas just keep coming. Like, I'll go, oh, I know what to do exactly after this. But like in this case, I have these two little sections, or now three, with the kind of different chords, and I'm just kind of like, eh, it's like okay, you know, it's not like blowing my mind that I've written something that I've never done before or something. So to me, I would probably just leave this alone for a while and then open it one day in a while and just see. But yeah, this is kind of my actual process and how I do stuff. And also, like, to point out to something that Dan was saying, like with effects and stuff, I don't think about like effects. I don't even, most of the time, I'm not even concerned about the like sounds that I'm using, like the pianos or the drums. I'm just trying to like get the idea out, and like I'm more after rhythm and melody, not so much like the sound design, the mixing. I'm just trying to get like the feeling of the song based on the parts that it is. You know what I mean? It's like the structure of the chords, the way the rhythm hits you. And so like I could replace all these drums, I could replace all these synth sounds and, you know, go in a completely different direction. But the most important part to me is like having the writing that is good. And so that's why I often work really fast and try to just like move past things like snare drums and stuff, because I'll figure that out later if I actually like the idea. And I think that's because I have this thing where I can't stand like going through, and a lot of producers would argue against this, but like I can't stand going through the process of like finishing a song if I don't think it's good. So some producers argue like you should finish everything you do, and like I think that works for some people, but I'm like a firm believer of the opposite. I think like you should finish a song if you think it should be finished and it seems like it's a good thing that you've done, you know. And that can be hard, you can be pretty critical on yourself, but I think you kind of know when you have a song that you should finish. Like, usually it's kind of screaming at you in the face and you're like, oh, I know exactly what to do with all this, you know?
No, I 100% agree with that. I work the same way. I don't believe in finishing every single thing you do, because not every single thing is going to be, you know, worthy of playing out.
Yeah, I just think it's like to me, like there's only so many vocals I could comp, because it literally makes me want to throw my computer out the window. When I'm like sitting listening to the same, like you guys saw it when we were doing processing your vocals, like I was already like triggered by like halfway through doing that vocal just being like, I can't stand doing this. So yeah, if I'm gonna finish a song, I have to be pretty excited about it, otherwise I just won't. That's the thing. And I kind of like that I like just will not finish it, because that just means that I'm not gonna waste energy on it, because I don't really like it. And also, something that I'm getting more and more comfortable with is just being like, it's okay that it's not done. And like, if an idea comes for it, it's always going to be there. You know what I mean? Like, I back up my computers, I do all these things, like it's not going to go away. And so I could have an idea 3 years from now, and all of a sudden the melody of like this little vocal thing that Ollie suggested I make, like this thing could just pop into my head. And I could be like, oh my God, there was that thing from that class. Like, I should just use that. And sometimes that's the best thing you can hope for with making ideas, is just having like little ingredients laying around that you can just like, because I was actually talking to a friend about this. Like, there's so many techniques that I wish I was more avid about using. And like, for example, like this pad thing I showed you guys at the beginning, like you can make dope stuff with that. I should be using that all the time. And that's like what my brain thinks. But then I realized that all this stuff is like in your mind, unless you know, concuss yourself and forget all these things or something. But like, for the most part, you're going to remember most of the techniques you've ever used. And the times where they'll come up are when you actually have the idea to use it. Not like, I should be just using this technique because I think it's cool and it's interesting. It's more like, oh, I have an idea for this song that involves kind of like a noisy pad. I should use that technique again. And it's like the same thing when I told you guys about like chopping ambiance. Like when I made like Quagga and all those like progressive songs that use that technique, there was a while where I was like, why am I not like just doing that to start a bunch of songs? And I kind of realized as I grew up, like, because you just have to go with what you're interested in. And if you're not like, if you don't find an application for that technique, then you're just going to like make a tiny loop and then get kind of annoyed. So you have to trust that like these techniques should come up when you need them to. And like when there's not, and I find that like when I work with other people, like when I collaborate with other people, they'll do something or say something that makes me go like, oh, I know how to do this crazy trick. And then I just like start doing stuff. And that's the most fun way of like using your knowledge base to, Yeah, because there's just, you know, like there's a million ways to make interesting sounds. And yeah, I used to be hard on myself about like constantly flexing all of those muscles. But the reality is it's just like got to come when it comes, I think. But it's good to know all these things and just have like these little tricks up your sleeve. And also when you save instrument racks because you can't figure out how to do it like I did. I don't know why that wasn't working. I'm pretty sure I matched all the settings. I'll have to go back through it, but yeah. Do you guys understand that from the beginning? Like what I was trying to do, basically like modulate the start point of it so it's just always going in different places. Yeah, it was weird that wasn't working. But yeah, so I think that's a decent place to stop just because I don't really have any more ideas. But do you guys have any questions based on anything today?
I just think the song was really nice.
Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, I mean, I'm. It's funny. I recently was like listening to some song, and it was just written in a chord structure I would never think of, and I'm getting kind of tired that I just always make the same chords. But it's just like how my brain hears music, so I kind of have to just like take what I can get. You know what I mean? But I do want to like work on making music in a slightly new way, and maybe that involves getting off Ableton and doing other things, you know. But yeah, thank you, man. I do need to just figure out some other things than just like straight chords, you know. But awesome. Well, thank you guys for joining, and we'll figure out a nice topic for next week, and I'll see you guys then.
Thank you, Pierce. I got a quick
thanks, Pierce.
Oh
yeah, go for it, man.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I just think in the future what could be a cool little exercise is, and I put it in the group chat, but essentially maybe take like something like this, like created in class, and then if the files get sent out, let everyone run with it and see where this cool direction go, maybe like a few weeks, and then because with everyone's different plugins and
ideas
about that could be interesting maybe.
So, do you guys want to do that with this?
I'd be down.
All right. Would rather? Would you rather like
always
stems?
All over that.
Stems or like a project?
Hot and loaded.
Well, stems would be easier for me because I don't have Ableton. But
well,
I think
I'll do stems and project, and then like if you have plugins, that's great. And if you don't, you can at least like take the MIDI files and stuff. All right. Cool. Yeah, that'll be fun. And then maybe next week we can kind of listen to what everyone did.
Nice.
Sounds good. All right. I'll send it in Discord. Awesome, guys.
One thing I can throw out there, Pierce?
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, so I've got a song that I'm going to put up on Discord here in a little while for you guys. I wonder if you could take a listen to it. It's nothing like you guys are used to listening to. But
he says that every time.
Yeah. It's actually pretty damn good, I think. And I want to get some feedback as far as what you might be able to put inside to fill in a little bit of the gaps. I mean, it's good enough without that right now, but I'm just trying to make it a little more modern.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'll check it out.
You'll know it. It'll stick out.
Awesome.
Thanks.
Well, I will see you guys next week then.
Cool. All right.
Thanks again.
Peace, guys.